Hello friends, this video on motion and measurement of distance part 1 is brought to you by examfear.com. No more fear from exam. Topics to be covered in this lesson are introduction, motion, measurement of length, units, types of motion. Now, before we talk about motion and measurement of distances, let me ask you a few questions. Just think about a situation that you are inside a room like this. And if I ask you, how big is this room? So, what would you tell me? I mean, of course, you can tell that, yeah, this room is very big or the room is very small. But if I ask you to give me a precise number, like which will define the exact size of the room. So how would you know the precise size of the room? How would you know how much is this distance of the room? How much is this much of the room? So how do you actually give that precise measurement? If I ask you, how tall are you? How do you measure your height? You need a parameter to measure it. Like often you would have heard that people say that, you know, he is 6 feet tall. So what is that 6 feet? That 6 feet is giving a precise measurement of how tall he is. Let's say you want to get a dress stitched. So you went to the tailor and he said that, okay, get me a piece of cloth and I'll stitch it for you. Now, when you go to the shopkeeper to buy a piece of cloth to get a dress stitched, the shopkeeper is going to ask you that, ma'am, how much of the cloth do you need? So again, you need to know that how much cloth do you need in order to get a dress stitched for you, because obviously different people would need different amount of cloth. A small girl of say 3 years old, he would need very less cloth. Somebody who is 5 feet tall would need more cloth in order to get the dress stitched. So in each of these examples, what do you see? You see that we need to measure the length in each of these cases. Whether you talk about the room, you want to measure the length and width of the room. If you talk about your height, you need to measure this length. Again, when you talk about a piece of cloth, you need to measure the length of the cloth, whether you need 5 meters of cloth or 2 meters of cloth or 3 meters of cloth. So that's how you basically measure length. So everywhere you want to measure something, right? Now the question is, what exactly are you trying to measure? Let's talk about few more scenarios. Let's say when you travel from one place to another in a car. So the car is basically moving from one place to another place. So basically the car is covering a length of the road. So if I ask you, how much length of the road did the car cover? So what would you tell me? So again, in this case, you want to measure the length of the road which was covered by this car. Similarly, let's say if you go out for a jog in the morning, so I might ask you that, okay, you went to the park for a jogging. So how much length of the park did you cover? So maybe you took 10 rounds of the park, right? Or you took 5 rounds of the park. So if I ask you, how much total length of the park did you cover? So again, what are you trying to measure? You are trying to measure the length of the park that is being covered. When you cycle from your home to school, so I can ask you that, how much distance was covered from your home to school? What was the length of the road from home to school? So in each of these scenarios, we are talking about measuring some length. Now that length could be the length of a cloth, the length could be the length of a room, and that length could be the length of the road which is being covered by an object which is moving. Because in these cases, you see the object is moving, whether it is the car or the bicycle or the person who is running. So the objects are moving. That is why they are able to cover some part of the road, and we want to measure that length of the road. So now the question is, what are we trying to measure? We are trying to measure length, and this length of the road is what is more popularly known as distance. So we are basically trying to measure distance. So when I say that the girl is cycling from her home to her school, so she is covering some part of the some length of the road. So that length of the road is nothing but the distance between her home and her school. So let's see, how do we define distance? It is the total path length an object travels from initial to final position. So let's take an example in order to understand it better. So let's say this is your home and this is your school, and this girl is traveling with her bicycle from home to school. Okay, so what would be the total distance here? So in this case, the path length from initial to final position. So what is the initial position? Home is the initial position, and final position is the final destination, that is school. So that means the total path length that she is going to cover from home to school, that path length is nothing but the distance. Right? So as she moves, she is actually covering the length of the path. So by the time she reaches school, she has covered the distance between home and school. Thank you. Please visit www.examfeo.com to watch more educational videos with a better experience. Please do not forget to like and subscribe to our YouTube channel for latest updates. Thank you once again.